agenda for my talk today, and that would include a simple introduction, a theoretical framework of the kind of study that I've been doing, objectives, methodology, and findings of the research project. This is actually one of the papers which I have already submitted at one of the conferences, and I've just revised it for this presentation. And the research is still ongoing. And to give a little background about myself is also, as Dr. Frith has already mentioned that, it's basically, it started with my PhD during the 1991 elections, and from then on I've been monitoring the elections for the past so many years. And there's a lot of changes that are taking place in India, and it's exciting to look at how we are using new media technologies in terms of elections. Some of the I've also studied the elections in Singapore, Philippines, as well as, of course, in India and the UK when I was there. It's interesting to see the difference in the Western models as well as the Asian adaptations of the Western models in terms of political communication. And it also comes down into understanding how the new media, especially in the last 5 years, have really changed the political discourse in the country itself. So this is basically a study on new media and the 2009 elections. Some of us are familiar with the country, but just to give you a brief overview, located in South Asia, India, of course, most of us would be familiar with, and one of the oldest civilizations of the world, population reached already 1.3 billion, so you can imagine how big it is compared to China and other countries. It's the largest democracy. Elections are held every 5 years, and what's interesting to note is that there are about 714 billion people go to vote. Elections are held over a period of 2 to 3 weeks overall. And what is important is also the change, and it's India has one of the youngest adult populations today. That's what we say is the most important factor, and what is going to lead to India's progress is basically this young generation, and who are going to be net savvy, and they are the ones who are going to lead the country in terms of how the progress is taking place and how it will take place in the future. And the whole idea behind these young voters is also the use of new media in trying to attract this new group of people who are the young voters. And the entire campaigning process went on into trying to tell the youth that, well, they are the ones who are going to be part of the India, the change in India, and that's why they need to participate. And all the campaigns that were taking place in the country were basically to create that awareness amongst the youth, to change those misconceptions, to change those, to change that indifference amongst the youth on the political process. So the way the entire campaigning process was handled was to bring the youth into the forefront of politics and political participation. So, and it was interesting that it was the there were three things that were very important. The first was the change, the use of media technologies by the government itself. We are looking at change in terms of e-democracy, where the internet is being used by most of the governments to interact with the citizens. Most of the information is through the websites which people can access. This is increasing the level of transparency, it is increasing accountability, and it is increasing the interaction between the citizens and the government itself. The Election Commission, which is the autonomous body which conducts the elections, and it's one of the major exercises that it has to undertake, also introduced all the new media in trying to create that awareness amongst the people of how they need to vote. It's one of the only country which where the Election Commission itself undertakes a campaign to tell people how to vote, what to do. And this time they have also introduced the new media and the electronic voting machines, because if we go into the historical aspects, there were a lot of problems, rigging of elections, malpractices, vote, you know, a lot of problems that were there, right? And these new media technologies were used to reach the young voters. And of course, this is a little more background in terms of how we are looking at the elections. Of course, it's a cultural political system where it's the kind of campaigning you have, music, dance, festivities, it's election fever, literally. And of course, in the 2009 elections, it was the huge advertising budgets, mass media was extensively used till the last 10 years. Television and radio were controlled by the government, so you didn't have so much of political advertising. But now that it has opened up, you have huge budgets, television, radio, newspapers, outdoor, new media extensively are being used for the elections. Media in India, the newspapers, national, local, regional, still dominate. You have so many television channels, radio is extensive, but still government initiatives in radio. It's not yet much into the privatization, just like the television, but yet it's being extensively used, where when it comes to elections, every possible media is used. And alternate media, you have audio cassettes, video cassettes. In the last election, which I was also doing, you had the video on wheels. You have these huge vans where you could show movies. But now, of course, it still continues, and the new media is also being used. Now, information and education, as we said, has been replaced by entertainment. Television keeps the Indians hooked on, and you can watch for 24 hours. Films, this morning I gave a presentation on Bollywood also, are the largest money spinners. So is television, and that films on the leaders are also being used as part of campaigning. Now, internet and mobile penetration, you can see, India is one of the fastest growing in terms of internet users. 45 million active internet users, 57 claimed internet users at the time the study was done, and it is increasing by the hour and the day. So we are looking at the kind of change that is taking place. Of course, it is still urban oriented, but what is the change in the rural setting is basically the mobile penetration. It's unbelievable the kind of change that is taking place now that you see the number of people using the mobile phones. And it's, as I said, though the internet penetration is basically urban-based, mobile penetration has reached the rural areas. And everyone, that's why that has become an important source of reaching the rural population. And you will find all kinds of people using it. So if you are looking, I mean, it's just one picture. When you look at the information, you say that, well, how the numbers are crossing, right? It's the 100 million mark. This figure is really important from India's point of view and opens gate for opportunities for both mobile phone or companies and operators alike. It's just not for them, but it's also for people who are using this to communicate, whether it is to do with health, whether it is to do with elections, or whether it's to open a bank or anything, a kind of opportunities, or just to tell them that this is the cost of the farmers, it's the cost of your potatoes, this is the cost of the grain, these are the best markets. So it's actually one of those two-step kind of processes which goes on, that people who have an internet in the rural community center are having through a computer, they log on, say, okay, this is what's the weather going to be, what's the cost of the market, what are the market rates, where should they go and sell. All this is being communicated from the internet, through the text, through the mobile phones to the people. So that way it is really revolutionizing the information communication system, where they can talk to each other and get information without having to move out, right? It's also saving the people from the middlemen who were, reducing corruption, it's reducing exploitation at different levels. So that way, you know, these kind of technologies are helping, and this have also been used in election communication. That's why we say diversity of the country has increased internet and mobile connectivity, and it calls attention to the use of traditional as well as new media in terms of elections. India's 2000, where the high tech, new technologies were being used, and this time it was the 2000 elections were being called as the digital elections. To continue with the study, we have looked at a lot of studies which have been using new media and elections across the world, and these were some of the studies, how the new media is increasing political socialization. A lot of, there's a journal of information and political and politics, which is an excellent source of information and giving details as to across the world how new media is being used by the political parties in engaging the electorate. And we have taken one or two of these studies. I've already done the last studies, of which you find are my own quotes. I have quoted my studies because I like to do them. Okay. Increases the need for people to look at what we have done, right? Political party websites, candidate websites, social networking sites all have become important in terms of election communication. You can't do without them these days, it looks like. Electorate is connecting to weblogs, websites, as well as setting up their own discussion forums, which itself is an indication of the interest in the political process. And in India, it becomes much more for engaging the youth. Social networking sites also, there is in the past 4 or 5, 2005 to 2009 and 10, a lot of studies have been done in the last one or two major conferences. They have become important. At least there are one or two panels which are giving an emphasis, and especially the political communication division is giving an emphasis on how these new technologies are being used and how they have been successful, right? In India, e-democracy, which I said, how most of the government is helping in terms of communicating with the public at large, and it is increasing the transparency and greater citizen information and interaction. So this is also the one of the important aspects in terms of the gradual process of change. And this study explores, of course, the how in Indian major parties in India have used new media, especially, as I said, giving the background of how the internet and mobile penetration is taking place. We are looking at a country which is technologically charged in a way, and if all of us are familiar with all the Indian tech-savvy people are across the world. And what is the whole idea behind it is also the kind of training that Indians are getting. It's basically from year 7 or year 8 that they are introduced to all kinds of software programs. You have all these small centers across the cities particularly, and now they are also penetrating into the rural areas where people can start getting tech savvy. So by the time they are in high school, they are in college, they are very tech savvy now and using all kinds of, they tell you how to use different programs and software, which is becoming even more interesting. So this study, what were the objectives? We were how the new media is being used during the elections, and we in-depth studies were carried out by the two major political parties, which was the Indian National Congress as well as the Bharatiya Janata Party, which are the two major parties, because they used it the maximum, and others also have been using it, but I have basically condensed it to see only how the two parties have done it, while the others are still doing it, but it's just as I put it as others. And how significant were the new media technologies, the internet and the social networking sites in terms of communicating with the electorate? And as I also mentioned earlier, the Election Commission, it's only the Election Commission in India only which runs campaigns to tell voters, please come and vote, freely and fairly, do not get influenced by money, by other, by cash or by kind, because it just happens that during the time of elections, especially when the rural areas who have the majority of voters, they are lured by cash, by kind, so they say, okay, any kind of temporary relief is better than nothing. So it's the Election Commission which runs campaigns to tell people that this is how you need to vote, go and vote. And this time they also introduced the electronic voting machines. So there was a campaign to tell people how to use those electronic voting machines. And you had the new media was also to engage the youth in telling them that this is a time that you need to participate in the elections. The next one, which I thought was really interesting, which came through in these elections, were the corporate social responsibility. Now, we understand corporate social responsibility in a different way in terms of doing all kinds of philanthropic activities, from building temples to associating with old age homes to associating with so many different things. But this time, what was different in the elections and in India were the major companies, the major corporates like the Tatas, which and the Birlas, which are the some of the biggest national corporates in making. I mean, if they are the largest, they are the ones who are doing everything, are making money. So they were the ones who engaged, who, as part of the social corporate responsibility, they ran several campaigns in order to awaken the people to create awareness of the political process. Now, most of the time, the problems that were there is people did not register. They were not registered voters. Wherever you were, you couldn't vote. People were indifferent to the political system. What do we care if some political parties get elected? We don't want to be part of it. There was only about 20% of urban interest. So what happened was this complete change that took place in terms of awakening the youth. The entire campaign that was taken up by the Tatas, which is the biggest industrial corporation, everybody joined. It was like a social movement where they said that, well, everyone through the new media, through the whether it was through the new media or through the traditional media, which we would say in terms of radio, television, film, these corporates ran campaigns. And I'll show you some of the clips which were by the youth and for the youth. And that led to an increase in the voter registration in terms and participation as well as awareness. And some of that's what I have looked at in detail. There were so many different, very interesting ads which make it so much more interesting to study. And after having done that, as I said, what my study was, how the different strategies, because here we are looking at the diverse country which is living in poverty, and here is the one is so techno-savvy, is already 24 hours connected to the internet. How are these different strategies that will link between the different groups of people? Because here this is a country which is so diverse in terms of rich and poor, there is nothing, and there is a big middle class too. And how were these strategies that were linked by the political parties to reach different groups of people? And how the online tools were used for offline activities also, which meant if there was a public meeting going on somewhere in any rural areas, here were the cameramen, they were taking all those videos and uploading it on whether it was on YouTube or on their websites. So, and then at the same time, there were people who were blogging, people who were watching these videos, they were analyzing everything that was, you were able to see at different levels, right? What were those perceived impact? Now this is basically, I've got this information, what was the impact of these campaigns from the various secondary sources. We have not done any primary data collection at this point of time, which would be nice to actually talk to the people as to how they have reacted to this information. But this is one big research organization which did do a study. So I've just taken the data at this point from them to see to do a rough analysis of the ads, of the campaigns itself. The methodology that we used, case study, multiple methods that were used for validating and making the data as reliable as possible from various sources. Analysis of themes of the various campaigns is what we are actually doing at this time. We've got collected all the ads and we are doing a content analysis. I'm doing it with one of the research students here. And of course, what we have done is a descriptive analysis of the websites of the major political parties based on certain categorization, which has been done in other studies. Use of mobile phones for advertising by political parties, just have a review of the data and which was there in the reports that were there in the newspapers, radio, and television. These were the different ways in which the media, new media was used. It was also, if you clicked onto Yahoo or clicked onto Rediffusion or Google, when you had just, even that information was bought in, that the moment you clicked Congress, you had, that was the first one or two hits that you could get. Observations and results, well-researched campaigns, ad agencies, PR consultants, IT experts, media advisors. It was the this was part of that case study. We found how it has become so important, just like all the, it's become a very organized system from 1984 to 1994 to 2004 and 2009. It's one of the most organized systems of campaigning that were taking place. Every party had their complete groups of people who were part of the campaign, who were planning the campaign. You had the media advisors, PR consultants, everything, just as you would say, all the spin doctors that were involved. Many campaigns were planned and executed by the youth, because this was basically also to increase that voter participation by 30% of the new voters which came into the 2009 elections. Themes and visuals mostly comprised of youth in the print ads. YouTube, Facebook, and blogging were used. Mobile text messaging was targeted to youth as well as in the rural areas. I'll show you some of those. What was that? There was also a campaign which told the political parties how the elections, the youth will not come to the elections, but the elections will need to go to the youth, which I thought was quite interesting. Maybe I'll just show it to you for half a minute. This was also one of the social. Yeah. It was just basically to say you don't find, you know, the young people in all those crowded places, but basically you will find them at the educational institutes too, having fun, enjoying with the. They don't want to be part of all these strikes and things like that, but they want to be more into doing things for themselves, for being better in terms of their education, in terms of using technologies. So all this was saying, okay, this is the past. I'll just move this along so that we just see the end. They will not be watching the old politicians, they'll be watching something that is more fun. This is what was important, we'll not go to the elections. So the whole idea behind the campaigns was basically to reach out to the youth themselves. And that's what was the idea behind most of the campaigns. This was what we found. Most of the political parties had their websites, and it was something different. And earlier, from 2000 to 2009, everything changed. It became so tech savvy. Major parties, BJP posted television commercials, public meetings, and on their websites and on YouTube. At the same time, the websites gave all the information, everything that one wanted. It was interactive. If you wanted to become a member of the party, you wanted to have a look at all the videos that were there for every group of target, every target group rather, there was a commercial, whether it was for the children, whether it was for women, whether it was for the rural farmers, whether it was for the tech-savvy persons, or it was for the 50-year-old or the 60-year-olds, there was some information that was specifically given. Very slick websites from what we saw in the a few years back. All information was posted, and if you wanted, you could support the Congress. Deeper into the websites, you also got to see all the campaign material. This was the Bharatiya Janata Party. This was the second, which I said these were the two parties which I really looked at. Online engaging began with three groups, said that, well, it's high time. They took up the initiative and said that, well, it's time to change, started blogs, started online engagement through campaigning, and this set the trend in terms of how the social networking sites were being used. Most of the parties had a Facebook presence. There were Twitter was a rage. You could get everyone was twittering away literally that you would see. It started with BJP and then all the others followed. And this was also something that was picked up from the Obama campaign. And that was extensively listed in the Indian media, how Obama used this during the 2008 and how it was successful, so we also can use. That's why I said in my earlier literature review also that the American campaigns become a model for other countries to follow or adapt them as part of the campaigning strategy. In fact, some years back also one of the earliest studies which we were doing in UK, and when we were doing a comparative analysis of elections in the US and UK, we said the Americanization of elections in UK and India. And we found there was how people are adapting those strategies. So this was also one of the ways. And the links that were provided, that's why we said that information from these was reported in the national media. What was going on in the new media was being translated into the television news as well as being covered in the national newspapers. So that way you will see how the whole idea that I was trying to do was how it was interlinking the traditional and the new media forms, right? The online videos, many hits. Maybe we want to see some of those, one of the ads. I don't know if this is the one. This is one of the ads which shows for, this is the Congress ad. Now, if you, if some of you are not familiar, this is the song which was from the Jai Ho adaptation is from Slumdog Millionaire, one of the most popular songs. So Congress bought the rights from them for quite a big amount. These are the former prime ministers and part of the Congress. It's one of the Congress campaigns. This was all over. If you see, it's had so many different. It's at the same time. Oops. Okay, I won't show the others now. To maximize use. Elections were extensively the internet version of Indian elections. What were being seen in the national newspapers were also on the internet. That was one of the ways in which you were completely being connected. Wherever you wanted to see that information, people had information. That was also the way in creating political awareness. And blogging became important, right? This was another new development that was. How much of blogging was taking blog by political parties, of course. We had the leaders themselves, so that it was, they wanted to reach out to the people individually, and by political analysts, social groups were continuously reviewing and updating what was happening. It was getting more and more interesting and more absorbing to see what was the changes that were taking place. And these discussion blogs kept the people interested in the campaigns, viewing their opinions, and then also it was the whole act of political socialization that was going on. And we are trying to also look at some of these blogs which were very interesting in terms of the interest that it was generating. At the same time, it was getting posted. That's what I was trying to also say, that anything that was happening, it was taken up from the new media, getting into the mass media, so that people were getting informed of in different ways as to how the information system was changing. Okay, so you had different ways in which, and these were the different, blogging became so important that there was so much of information that went on over the few days and months, 2 months. other channels went on with from CDs, audio cassettes, compact discs, and election operations, as I told you, the Election Commission introduced the, why that got cut off. Now, this was an important development that, the electronic voting machines. It was earlier we would have pages and pages of ballot papers, and this was something, it was being tested from 1998, 1999 it was, they started testing whether this would work or not, and finally in 2009 it worked. This was an important development because one, it stopped the malpractices that were going on where people could just take those ballot papers and stuff in here. You could, in those 10 minutes or 15 minutes, only three could be cast, and there was a number you had to have so much of. It was a way in which you stopped lots of malpractices, as well as the ballot papers, as well as the illiterate people who would have to put their fingers wherever they were asked to do so. But here they could actually see the symbols on the voting machine and they could put in their data. Another development was the National Election Watch. It was one of the ways in which you could get information about the changes that were taking place. It was also a way in which you could get information regarding the political parties, the developments, anytime there were criminal cases against people, which you could monitor. And it was also in the last few years, we saw a lot of criminals were in politics, but this time it was saying that the new media allowed everyone to have an access to the candidate's background. Now, this was another development that, apart from the National Election Watch, which you saw. Right, this was one of the important websites which said that please spread the word about this website and help others to make an informed choice as well. Now, if you were in any state, you wanted to vote and you wanted to know who your candidates were, right? You could go onto this website and maybe you could check out who were the candidates, and you would also find if there were criminal cases against him or her. Yeah? And this allowed, because this, yeah, that's what it was. This is last year's election. So this time, whenever you found people like them, you would say that, well, if they were the ones, you saw their background and you could vote from anywhere, right? And you could see who are the people, what were the total assets, what were the age, what were the educational qualifications, right? So this way, it was also one of the ways that new media allowed people to know what they were voting for. Now they have said, okay, this was a wrong choice made, next week, next time we will see. So from 2004 to 2009, you had 30-40% of the people were totally disqualified because of their background. And people were seeing that they should not be allowed to stand in an election. It is something, you know, in many other Asian countries and developing countries, you find that yes, there were a lot of criminal cases, but still they are the winners and they continue with their problems. Okay. Sorry. And this was what I was also saying, that, well, these were the ways in which the changes that were taking place and how the new media was being used in terms of creating that awareness about the public as such. And these were the, creating the voter awareness campaigns by the industrial groups. How the Tatas, the Birlas came up with new, using this to create that political awareness. They said that, well, it is high time that we became a better informed society in the world. And then it says that was the whole idea of Jagore, which means the Jagore campaigns, which are listed, where I said, is basically the Awaken India. We're doing a major study on how this is as part of, you know, another issue for corporate social responsibility. And looking at this website, it says that it's the Tata Tea. Tata's is one of the, as I said, bigger industrial groups. They started this campaign, an online registration campaign. And this site allowed you to register. They said it was the 1 billion votes they wanted. 35 cities they started, and it went across the entire country. It also told you how you could register. It was the voter registration campaign. So you finally decided to wake up, how to vote. Now enter your details. Now this was the way in which the young people who were not registered, they said they were not registered anywhere. And if they were registered, people just went and voted for them. So there was so much of problems that were taking place in voting. And this was a campaign to start the process of moving the youth from being non-registered to being registered, right, as voters. So wherever you were in the country, supposing you were in one part, you were in Mumbai and you were you are from Mumbai and living in Delhi. So you didn't say, okay, I'm not going to vote because I'm not registered, I'm living somewhere else. This was a campaign which allowed you to register online wherever you were, and it gave you, it took you just 5 minutes. Otherwise, it was the biggest headache to going and standing in a municipal office for hours. No one wanted to go and take that headache, right? And even if you got registered, I remember my own personal experience when I started doing election, I said, oh, it is my duty, I must go and vote. But the time I went to the local, my father-in-law said, no need to go and vote. There's too much of problem over there. There's so much of police. Something might happen. I said, no, let us go. When I went over there, somebody had already cast my vote. So that was the end. And then everyone thought, literally you make a laughing stock of yourself. Well, you wanted to go and vote, and there was someone who's already voted. I said, well, these were the things which had to be stopped. And that's what, you know, all kinds of people got elected. Might was right. So, and you were not registered. The maximum problem was because you were not registered. And here was a way in which you were told you could. Simply, the process was there, the site was there, and it allowed you to register wherever you were. It went through the entire process. And when you come to the end, you say that, well, enter all your details. You see where you had to finally print your name. Click on print. It also showed you how to go and print. And finally, well, the whole process, voter registration done, it took you just 5 minutes. And this increased people to actually become aware as well as register over. I don't have the exact details, but at the time they said that 500,000 had, within a few days of it started, had already voted, had already registered. That's the first step of the process. And how did they go about attracting them to this site? That was the most interesting part. Now that you have seen the site, you see how people were actually motivated to go to this site. Now, nothing could be easier than this, to follow instructions and at least register to vote. Total time spent 5 minutes, and there you could just register. And how did people go to this site? That was part of the fun, right? Tata Tea, this Jagore campaign and
election ke din agar aap vote nahi kar rahe ho तो आप सो रहे हो।
वोट दो किसको वोट दे?
और वोटर रजिस्ट्रेशन वो कैसे करें?
जागोरे.com वोटिंग के सारे प्रॉब्लम्स सॉल्व
शायद। दिस इज दैट दे आर सेइंग ओके इट्स कॉर्पोरेट सर्च दे आर टेलिंग यू ओके हैव टी एन लॉग ऑन टू जागोरे.com. दिस इज बेसिकली वन ऑफ आई मीन दिस इज कंप्लीट कमर्शियल किस बेसिकली एवरीवन I'll translate it as soon as you see this.
What's the problem?
Sora is everyone sleeping.
I am not sleeping, okay?
Election ke din, agar aap vote nahi kar rahe
ho, to aap so rahe ho.
Jagore.com pe jaiye, voting ke liye register kijiye.
Okay, I'll quickly translate this in a minute. This is basically an ad which is showing the youth all, it's an election day and everyone's gone to see a movie because it's a holiday. So here are these youth coming and saying, why are you sleeping? Why are you sleeping? So everyone's getting angry. So saying, have tea, because of course they're promoting their tea also. Have tea, all of you are sleeping. So the girl says, I'm not sleeping. It's a holiday. I've come to see a movie. So the youth says, on an election day, if you are not voting, you are sleeping then. And then they says, what do you mean? How are we going to vote? He's saying, go to jagore.com, which I showed you that website, and register as a voter and exercise your right as an. So there were several such campaigns which directed the youth to go for the to go and vote. And it was basically, you had the use of celebrities. If you we look at these websites, there are so many websites which are actually directing the people to go to these website and actually vote. And all these ads that you see are basically it's telling us that, well, you need to go to that particular website in order to register and thereby exercise your vote. And it was basically in English, and I'll show you another one maybe. It was not only in Hindi, but it was in so many different languages. It was translated in different languages. Celebrities became part of it, as well as different major companies, right? And all these companies basically came in front. They said it became a social movement of Jagore, and everyone had to go and register themselves. These are the two IT companies, Wipro and Infosys. They had their managing directors, all the tech savvy people who are saying that, well, it's part of our being a citizen of this country, everyone should vote, and it's high time we bring a change in the country, and it's a democratic right that we need to exercise. So this was another My Idea campaign, was by another group of people who said that, well, you need to vote, exercise your vote, and it included celebrities, and this was also one of the popular movie stars, Abhishek Bachchan. Everyone came out to participate in this particular movement. And online reporting became important. Vote Report India was also another issue in terms of reviewing what the changes were taking place and how one could get that information and how to vote, how to change, and what are the ways in which we could make the change in the political system. And these were also some of the ways in which we were able to get that information. And then we looked at how the mobile phones were being used. As I said, the penetration is so high in the rural areas. In 2004, it was an experiment, and people were really shocked because you could hear the Prime Minister's voice himself, right? He was the one who was calling up with so many text messages as well as phone calls, saying that, well, this is the BJP started that campaign, which the Prime Minister himself was called up and said that we need your vote and vote for this particular party. It was a surprise in 2004, but it became a norm in the 2009 elections. 250 million of India's 400 million mobile subscribers got this message in terms of voting for it was the Election Commission which did it, which was the parties which did it. So people were literally inundated with the number of parties. Then you had the networks that were built, mobile networks too, in terms of Friends of BJP, Social Network, and My Today, all the SMS campaigns went on and on with that to support the people, right? And of course, mass media campaigns. It was important to see that, well, all the newspapers, radio, television, of course, which are definitely part of the whole system, were being used for advertising. Election rallies, elections are fun and entertainment. So you had the election tours of the party leaders. That's why we said all the other traditional forms, folk forms, were all being used as part of reaching the diverse Indian electorate. New media enabled the integration of many of these. All the audio, whatever was happening offline, were also incorporated online, right? That was the way, and it was also being reported extensively. Political festivity, religion, rallies, merchandising, everything became is what was there, which was there at the level of the grassroots as well as in the online systems, right? Impact of the campaigns. I need to rush. Okay, professionally driven election campaigns. How much was the impact? Of course, radio and television got the maximum hits, but at the same time, what was important is there was a high level of increase in the registration of voters, which was one of the good things, which might, by the next election, you will have so many different online registrations. But the websites, online campaigns were not so effective because still it is a something that new that is happening in the country itself, right? And as I said earlier too, it is the young people, right? It's the people, the youngsters who are driving force behind the entire process of campaigning itself. Most advertising campaigns in mass media had better recall amongst the youth, and even 67% and 53% having seen those ads, which were so many, was also a very high number compared to what it would be at least 5 to 10 years back when we had done a survey. It used to be 10 to 15%. So this has been a great shift as I would look at it, right? 10th of them visited the website. Politics, local, and now it has become national, it has become international. A lot of people from overseas are also participating in the blogs and in terms of writing about them. And interpersonal forms of communication also continue to be popular. People still want to see them at mass meetings, at rallies, door-to-door campaigns, and it is the interpersonal campaigns are also mediated, right? When you have a public meeting, you have a video also being shown or a film being shown on the parties. Or you have CCTV cameras across where you can have a look at what is happening. The use of online brand campaigns in India will continue, especially in targeting youth and all other changes. There has definitely been a shift that has taken place since the 2009 elections, and the important fact is the involvement of youth. And it can't just be online, it has to be supported by the mainstream media as well as offline activities. So drawing from the theoretical perspectives also, we find that, well, they have changed the way in which parties are communicating with each other and with the public at large. That is, it has helped in creating awareness, participation, as well as consciousness. And we also, as you know, people, Indians who are living overseas, also are so excited about this change that is taking place. It is making people think about it. Maybe in a few years they might have overseas voting, like it's never been done before, but that is one of the issues which they are thinking about, given the fact that there are over 15 million Indians living out of the country. Given the nature of the electorate, things have to change. The leaders at this time spoke the language, they used the technology, and reached people where they had to be. As I told you in the beginning, elections, people will not go for the elections, but elections will need to go to them, and that was what has happened, right? All internet, online, and offline strategies were also linked to the internet and official websites that were totally coordinated with each other. Finally, internet has extensively increased engagement in the youth and adults, and that is what we are looking at, corporate social responsibility. That was one of the important changes that have taken place, and this is also extending in terms of other social issues which the corporates are taking up. They are taking up on corruption, they are taking up on women's issues, they are taking on education, on children, and greater transparency, accountability of the politicians, everything. I mean, it is becoming, all these issues are being taken up by corporates, and big campaigns are being run in order to create that awareness amongst the people, right? And of course, we said, as I said, new media technologies will set future online political discourses that will take place, and how will the people be engaged over the course of time. The future, given the present trends, Indian elections will be one with most exciting for researchers to study the interlinks between the online and offline communications. And to conclude, my next chapter is Engaging Any Democracy, which I've already written. I hope it's accepted. Yep. So that's the conclusion. I hope you've enjoyed the presentation, and a lot is happening. Cyber safe space, communities that are being developed, and that's about it. Okay? Thank you so much. Questions?